Hi, I'm Norman Wildberger. Today we're going to have a look at an interesting problem that concerns a ladder being moved around a corner. We have a corridor here and a corridor there. We want to move a ladder around. We want to know what's the largest size ladder that we can do it. We assume this quadrant is A, this quadrant is B. And the problem is interesting because it's one of the few problems in geometry where cube roots appear. We'll see that the cube roots of these quantities appear in the solution. So to start off, we start with, say, a ladder in that position there. We let this spread be S. Then this quadrant's P is equal to B over S. And this quadrant's R is equal to A over 1 minus S. That's those two. And then Q, the quadrants of the ladder itself, is given by the triple quad formula involving P and R. So our problem is to find S so as to minimize Q. We want to find the minimum possible Q, but Q depends on S in a sort of an indirect way. We're going to have to introduce a little bit of ideas from calculus, but I don't assume that you know any calculus. So we're going to give you a bit of a crash course on differentials and how to think about them. So here's an arbitrary function of S, call it Q of S. S here, Q there, a small or infinitesimally small displacement ds there results in a corresponding change dq in the q direction. A minimum point, like right there, is characterized by having a tangent which is horizontal. And that means that if you displace by a small amount ds, the corresponding small increment in q is zero. So a minimum or a maximum is characterized by the condition that dq equals zero. That's going to be important for us. That's how we're going to get this minimum idea. Here's an example of how it works in a simple but important example. Q of s equals s squared. That's a function of s. Suppose we change s by a small amount ds. Then the change in q is the new value of q minus the old value of q, which is this. And since ds is very, very small, ds squared is super, super small. In fact, we'll consider it to be zero. So ds squared is effectively zero, which gives a dq equals 2 times s times ds. That's a differential relation between q and s. Here's another important example. We have p and r, and we're considering the product pr. Suppose we change p by a small amount dp and r by a small amount dr, then what's the corresponding change in the product, p times r? There's the new product, there's the old product. The difference amounts to p times dr plus r times dp, and we've ignored that additional dp times dr term because that's super small. So dpr equals that combination. That's going to be important for us later too. All right, so now let's return to our general triple quad formula. Q, P, and R related this way. And we suppose that we are still after the situation where Q is minimized, so dq equals zero. So we have to analyze this situation differentially. Okay. Let's apply the first example. Here we have something squared. So its d is 2 times that quantity times the d of what's in here. Dq minus dp minus dr. And for a minimum, dq is going to be equal to zero. On the right-hand side, the change d of pr is what we calculated above. It's p dr plus r dp. So after we replace this with zero, we need to do a little bit of playing around with this. First, we're going to cancel twos. And then we're going to square the entire equation so that we can replace q minus p minus r squared with 4pr. So we do that, we square everything, that becomes 4pr, we get this squared equals 2 squared is 4, and this thing squared. Now we have a relation, we cancel the 4s, we expand out with dps and drs, get all the drs on one side, all the dps on the other side, we get this relation here, and then we cancel the r
minus p's from both sides. And we get the important result that for a minimum, when q is minimum, p dr squared equals r dp squared.
That's a very general result that applies to the triple quad formula in great generality. Now let's go back to our special situation where p was given by b over s and r was a over 1 minus s.
And a and b are constants, and let's now introduce the cubed roots of those, so we'll let capital A be little a cubed and capital B be little b cubed. So we have to take differentials of these two expressions. This one is dp equals minus b over s squared ds. I'll leave that as an exercise. What you have to do is you have to apply the product rule up there, multiply by s, get s times p equals b, and then take the differential of that, get that. Similarly, dr equals a over 1 minus s squared ds. Now we have these four quantities, p, r, dp, and dr. We're going to substitute into there. So p times dr squared over here equals r times dp squared over here. In this relation, we canceled an a and b on both sides, cancel an s and an 1 minus s from the bottom. Cross multiply, we get as cubed equals b times 1 minus s all cubed. We replace the a and the b with a little a cubed and little b cubed. We take the cube root to both sides, and we get as equals b times 1 minus s, giving us finally that when q is minimum, the spread s is little b over a plus b. All right, now that we know what s is, we can fill out all the rest of the diagram pretty easily. So here's little a cubed, there's little b cubed, there's s, which is b over a plus b. So 1 minus s over here will be little a over a plus b. And then you can easily just plug into the formulas that we've already got, that p, for example, is b squared a plus b, r is equal to a squared a plus b, this is a squared b, this is a b squared. And the triple quad formula then can be solved to get q equals a plus b all cubed. So that's the final answer. The largest ladder that we can fit through this corner has quadrants little a plus little b cubed. Or in other words, the cubed root of the quadrants a plus the cubed root of the quadrants b all cubed. Also, in addition, this spread in the original rectangle here in the corner, called R, that's going to be B over A plus B by Pythagoras. That, in terms of little a and B, is given by B cubed over A cubed plus B cubed. And I'll leave it to you as a little algebraic exercise to show the relationship between this little R and the S that we found before, is that R equals S cubed over 1 minus 3S plus 3S squared. And I challenge those of you who would like to think in terms of classical trigonometry to find the corresponding relationship between the corresponding angles in this situation. That was a little bit of a hard problem. Well done if you've managed to follow it all. Next time we're going to go back to something, in fact, much older. We're going to go back to trisecting an angle, a problem that the ancient Greeks struggled with. I hope you'll join me. I'm Norman Wildberger. Thanks for listening.